कुंडा गिरी गोवर्धन
रासा लीला सर्वमनोरा Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Jaya Krishna Balaram, Krishna Balaram, Krishna Balaram, Jaya Krishna Balaram,
Jaya Krishna Balaram, Krishna Balaram, Krishna Balaram, Jaya Krishna Balaram.
Jaya Radha, Krishna Chandra Radha, Krishna Chandra Radha.
Jaya Radha, Krishna Chandra Radha, Krishna Chandra Radha.
Jaya Nittai Gauranga, Nittai Gauranga, Nittai Gauranga, Jaya Nittai Gauranga.
Jaya Nittai Gauranga, Jaya Nittai Gauranga. Nitai Goranga, Jaya Nitai Goranga,
Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Jaya Jaya Prabhupada,
Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Prabhupada.
ज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः नमः ॐ विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिन्निति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे. इन दिस सेशन वी विल बी हियरिंग फ्रॉम the 7th chapter of the 10th canto entitled The Killing of the Demon Trinavarta. So the opening verse of this chapter, it is spoken by Parikshit Maharaj, who is hearing from Shukadev Goswami. Parikshit Maharaj is telling Shukadev Goswami, yat shrinvato अपैति अरतिर वितृष्णा सत्वं च शुद्ध्यन्ति सत्वं च शुद्ध्यति अचिरेण पुंसः भक्तिर हरौ तत्पुरुषे च सख्यं तदेव हारं वद मन्यसे चेत. परीक्षित महाराज इज टेलिंग टू शुकदेव गोस्वामी, all the various activities exhibited by the incarnations of the Supreme Personality of Godhead are certainly very pleasing to the ear and to the mind. simply by hearing these activities, the dirty things in one's mind immediately vanish. All the dirty things in the heart, in the mind, they vanish. But something more important, what Parikshit Maharaj tells Shukadeva Goswami, generally we are reluctant to hear about the activities of the Lord. I mean, Parikshit Maharaj is very eager to hear, but he is putting himself in the position of a common man of this world, and he is presenting before Shukadeva Goswami. Generally, we are reluctant to hear about the activities of the Lord. But Krishna's childhood activities are so attractive that they are automatically pleasing to the mind and ear. Krishna's childhood activities or pastimes have a special attraction. Among all the pastimes Krishna himself performed, his childhood pastimes are the most attractive. Most attractive. Bala Leela. And we have experienced that if there is a small child at home, that child becomes the center of attraction for all the family members. Is it not? So, even the child trying to speak, even if it speaks in a broken language, for somebody who loves the child speaking in the broken language is very, very, very attractive and interesting. So you can imagine the Supreme Personality of Godhead appearing as a human child in the house of Nanda and Yashoda, how he would be speaking very sweetly and giving so much pleasure to the devotees, beginning with Yashoda, Nanda, Maharaj, and the other cowherd women, cowherd men, the boyfriends. Everyone would be enchanted, enthralled so much by Krishna's every movement, every word, every action, every thought, like that. So, Parikshit Maharaj is specially praising the childhood activities of Krishna. Then he says, thus one's attachment for hearing about material things, which is the root cause of material existence, vanishes. Somehow we have got some attraction for material things due to association, material association. We have developed that. Now, how will that go away? Automatically, it is gone when we hear Krishna's childhood pastimes. Two things happen. When we hear Krishna's childhood pastimes, we become attracted to Krishna, and we also cleanse our heart of all the dirty things, that material contamination that is there in the heart. Gradually, one develops devotional service to the Supreme Lord simply by this process of hearing, like all of you are now hearing. Simply by this process, you develop devotional service to the Lord gradually. And you also develop attachment for Krishna. You develop devotional service means you keep advancing in devotional activities, and that leads to attachment for Krishna, Rati. And friendship with devotees who give us the contribution of Krishna consciousness. We develop friendship with such devotees because we like to hear more. And such devotees, their only business is to speak about Krishna's activities. So, therefore, Parikshit is telling Shukadeva Goswami, if you think it fit, kindly speak about those activities of the Supreme Lord. He is specifically asking Shukadeva Goswami, kindly narrate the childhood pastimes of Krishna. So Shukadeva Goswami was very pleased with this statement of Parikshit Maharaj, and he continued speaking about Krishna's childhood pastimes. And when Krishna was about 3 months old, when he was an infant on his mother's lap, he killed Putana, who came to kill him, but he delivered Putana. So after that, when Krishna was 3 months old, he was just trying to turn backside up. Child is lying, and as he starts growing, he slowly starts trying to turn upside. And before even he actually began crawling, Mother Yashoda observed a ritualistic ceremony with her friends for the good fortune of the child. So every action of Krishna is very, very, very pleasing for Yashoda and all the inhabitants of Gokula. Very, very pleasing. Because Krishna is supremely attractive. The name Krishna means supremely attractive. So he is supremely attractive because every bodily feature of his is very attractive. Every movement of his is attractive. Every word he speaks is attractive. Everything he does, every relationship with him is attractive. So that is Krishna. And such a ritualistic ceremony generally performed with ladies who also have small children. They all gather together and they have this. So now Krishna, when this ritualistic ceremony began, Krishna was feeling very, very, very sleepy. Now, mind you, Krishna is a Supreme Lord. So he has something else in his mind. Why? At the time the ceremony is beginning, he is feeling very sleepy. So Mother Yashoda, what did she do? Because she had so many other engagements, she's invited her friends and all the other covered women, and they have to do so many ritualistic ceremonies. So she thought, oh, child is feeling very sleepy. Let him take little rest while we do the other ceremonies. So she put the child underneath a household cart called Shakata. And while the child was sleeping, she engaged in other business pertaining to the auspicious ritualistic ceremony. Now, underneath the cart was a cradle, and Mother Yashoda had placed the child in the cradle. Now, what happened? Krishna, after some time, he woke up. And then he began kicking his legs. Small children, they want to draw the attention of the mother that I have woken up now. They will of course cry, but Krishna also began kicking his leg. Now this, with the kicking of his small legs, which were, it is described in the Sanskrit, it is like his legs were very, very, very tender and soft. Even when he is grown up, his legs are very, very, very soft. And you can imagine, as a small child, 3-month-old child, legs will be very, very soft. Those soft legs, he's kicking means he's just being like this little, just movement, that's all. What is the force of kicking of a small 3-month-old child? But that kicking shook the cart, and the cart collapsed with a big sound, breaking completely and spilling all its contents. Actually, that cart was, in the cart was an asura hiding. He is called as Shakatasura. In fact, when we chant Krishna's 108 names, we say Shakatasura Bhanjanaya Namaha. Obeisances are offered to Krishna, who killed the Shakata demon, the cart demon. Shakata means cart. So this demon word had appeared in the form of a cart, and those covered men and women, they are innocent. They don't know that a demon is present in the form of the cart. So that cart has been loaded with so many things, and the cart is lying in one place, and Yashoda has gone and placed the child underneath the cart in a cradle. So Krishna successfully actually delivered the demon, killed the demon, but that killing is also auspicious because the demon is delivered by Krishna. But Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj and all the cowherd men and women became very anxious for the safety of the child. So when they heard that sound, crashing sound of the cart, they immediately came to the spot, rushed in great anxiety. And Mother Yashoda immediately took the child on the lap and began to breastfeed him. Then other types of ceremonies were performed to actually shower blessings of the Brahmanas on the child. None of them knew who this Krishna is. They didn't know Krishna is the Supreme Lord. They are doing everything to protect the child against calamities. So after this was over, then another day, when Mother Yashoda was sitting with her child on her lap, suddenly the child became extremely heavy. And then actually Krishna had assumed the weight of the entire universe. Weight of the entire universe. So she was astonished. Why is the child become so heavy? She is barely able to lift the child. Somehow with great difficulty she put the child on the ground. And then after that she became busy with some other household work. The child has been placed on the ground. Meantime, another demon associate of Kamsa, Drunavarta, he came in the form of a whirlwind and he covered the whole tract of land with dust. A dust storm. Dust storm. Nobody could see each other and there were particles of sand everywhere in the air. And the gopis were all overwhelmed. Where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? So Yashoda said, I just left him there. And they come to that spot and they are not able to see the child at all. Then they all began searching for the child. Where is the child? Where is the child? Now the child is carried away by this Trunavarta whirlwind demon up high in the sky. Now when the demon was carrying, Krishna had made himself very light. After the demon went certain height, then Krishna started becoming heavy. This is one of these siddhis, to become heavier than other heavy things, heavier than the heaviest it's got. So Krishna started becoming heavy. And then the demon tried to become heavier than Krishna, but at a certain point the demon could not become any more heavy. Krishna became heavier than the demon. Then the demon was trying to actually throw away the child. But Krishna was firmly holding on to the demon's neck with his two hands. And the demon could not throw Krishna. And he could not himself bear the weight of the child. So then the demon came down crashing, fell on a stone. He lost his life, fell down and lost his life. Then suddenly when that crashing sound came, all the cowherd men and women rushed to that spot to see what happened. They saw the demon crashed and baby Krishna is happily on the region of this chest of the demon near the neck. Small child is playing. So immediately Mother Yashoda again picked up the child. And they were struck with wonder. How could this demon be actually killed and the child is safe? They couldn't understand what is going on actually. What is really happening? They began to think that the child is very, very fortunate to be safe. And the demon, because of his past sinful activities, he deserves to be punished for all his sinful activities, and thus he was killed by this great fall. So thinking like that, they immediately took the child, and again Mother Yashoda called for the Brahmanas to bless the child with safety and protection and auspiciousness, everything. Actually, Krishna is the source of all auspiciousness, but they don't know So they're calling Brahmanas, and Brahmanas are chanting from the Vedas some hymns for bringing in auspiciousness. Then one day, when Krishna actually was on the lap of his mother, he began to yawn, open his mouth wide open. Then Mother Yashoda saw within the mouth of Krishna the entire universe. Again, she became very afraid of something, some inauspicious evil spirit is attacking my child. So she simply closed her eyes and began to pray to Narayana, 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 please protect my child. One after another, something or the other keeps happening. So she's praying to Narayana. And after some time, she felt confident that the child is now safe. And she opened her eyes and she saw Krishna is just lying normally on her lap. So she doesn't know this child actually is a Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is the embodiment of not only one universe, but all the universes. Because that is his energy resting on him. All his energies are resting in him. So he doesn't know that. So she was just completely bewildered when she saw the universe within his mouth. And she thought some evil spirit is attacking the child. So these are some of the wonderful pastimes Krishna had performed simply for sake of giving pleasure to his devotees, and for also he had come with the purpose of reducing the burden of the world. So as a small child, one demon Putana, then another demon Shakatasura, another demon Trinavarta, one demon was used to come to Vrindavan to actually attempt to attack the child and kill the child, but they ended up themselves getting killed because Krishna is the Supreme Lord, nobody can kill him. But these were the wonderful pastimes that Krishna displayed in Vrindavan. So I'll take some questions now. Goddess Lakshmi appeared during the churning of Mandara Mountain. Is this the first appearance of Goddess of Fortune? No, it's not the first appearance. The Goddess of Fortune is the eternal consort of the Supreme Lord. So whenever the Supreme Lord appears as an incarnation, the Goddess of Fortune also appears with him. So this is not the first time the Goddess of Fortune is appearing while the churning of the milk ocean is happening. We hear her being the eternal consort of most incarnations of the Lord. Not most incarnations, all incarnations of the Lord, Lakshmi Devi is eternal consort. So she always accompanies him in different forms, in different ways, in different manifestations. So just like the Lord manifests in a particular way, Lakshmi also manifests herself in some particular way. So one of the examples is given that in the Bhagavatam, that she manifested herself when the churning of the milk ocean happened. That's all. If Madhvacharya, a Paramacharya from this Parampara, is Madhvacharya a Paramacharya from this Parampara? Yes. If so, why is teaching of original source Vishnu differ from Lord Chaitanya's description of the original source as Krishna? Now, the understanding is Supreme Personality of Godhead, Bhagavan, is one person, one and only one person. Please understand this very carefully. God is one, Supreme Personality of Godhead is one. But he is not limited like us. If we say somebody is one person, then we expect we'll see one form. We'll see one form. But God is unlimited person. One person, unlimited. So he has got unlimited forms. Anantarupam. Advaitam achyutam anadim anantarupam. Adyam purana purusham navayavvanam cha. Brahma Samhita clearly explains this. that Advaitam, all the forms of the Lord are non-different from each other. They are identical with each other. They are the one and only one same person, Krishna. Advaitam, Achyutam, all of them are Achyuta, all of them are infallible. They never, even when they incarnate, they don't come under the influence of the material energy. Rather, they are the masters of the material energy. They are completely controllers. They don't come under the control of material energy. Achyutam, Anadim, they don't have any other source other than they themselves. So Anadim, they don't have any other external source. Anadim, Anantarupam, and they are present or manifest in unlimited number of forms. Unlimited forms. So where is the question of differentiating between Vishnu and Krishna when they are the same person? Why do you think Madhvacharya is preaching something different than Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Same person. In a certain context, Madhvacharya describes Vishnu as supreme. In another context, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is describing Krishna as supreme. So you have to understand the context in which they are referring. Okay? Sometimes when Shukadeva Goswami is describing Krishna's pastimes, he is describing Krishna as Vishnu. So what is the wrong there? Some people will say, why Krishna is described as Vishnu? Because there's only one person there. Vishnu and Krishna are the same person only. Prabhupada gives a nice example for helping us understand. Supposing, you have experience that there's a gentleman at home. He is the father of his children. He is the husband of his wife. He is the son of his parents. Supposing it's a family, joint family, they're staying together. So then he has relationship at home of a very intimate nature with his parents, with his wife, with his children. Three relationships. Different kind of relationship, but they are all very intimate. Now he works in some big company, big institution as a CEO. So when he goes to work, he'll be going in a very, very big car, and in the office he is the topmost person. So everybody will show that respect to him, that respect for the seniority, position, power, etc. So his dealings there are totally different, but he is the same person, mind you, the same person. And he may go to a tennis court to play some tennis with his friends, other CEOs who are his friends on the same level. So they freely talk to each other, not as intimately as he interacts with his parents or wife or children at home, but more informal than at office, than the company. So his dealings are different, his mood is different, his dress is different, his appearance is different, but he is the same person. So that is the example Srila Prabhupada gives to help us understand. It's a crude example, of course, but still you can get the sense that the person is the same, but the appearance is different. The nature of relationship is different. The kind of people he interacts with are different. You see, it's appropriate for the position, for the particular position. And he also conducts himself in that way, according to the position. Same thing with Krishna. So Krishna as the child of Mother Yashoda and Nanda is in a very, very, very intimate relationship with his devotees in Vrindavan. That intimacy is not there when he is in Mathura and when he is in Dwaraka. That intimacy is not there. But there also, there are nice, loving relationships. But they are not as intimate as in Vrindavan. So that's why the differences are there, but the person is the same. Person is not different. Next question. The various pastimes as described in Srimad Bhagavatam seems beyond one's intelligence, perception and imagination. Only Krishna can know his potencies and only to some extent by his devotees. It seems impossible to understand the Janma and Karma of Krishna. Impossible means if we try to understand using our material intelligence, material logic, nothing will fit into material logic. Nothing will be understandable using material intelligence. No. We simply have to hear and we have to actually make advancement in Krishna consciousness. We have to purify our material contamination. All material misconceptions have to go away from our heart, consciousness. Then we begin to understand what is transcendence, what is spirituality, entirely different from our material conception of this world or ourselves or things around us. There is one reality called material existence. There is another reality, a superior reality, a higher reality called spiritual world, spiritual existence. So we have to actually graduate to that spiritual existence by purification of the heart, by spiritualizing our consciousness, by becoming Krishna conscious. Then we begin to understand and appreciate, oh, this is something entirely different and it is so wonderful, so nice. So we will begin to understand and appreciate as we keep hearing, as we keep purifying our consciousness, as we give up these material misconceptions, you see, then it will, everything will fall in place. What kind of attachment is good for a sannyasi? A sannyasi or anybody else, not only sannyasi, for everyone, what is recommended is you become attached to Krishna, Krishna's activities, Krishna's form, Krishna's name, Krishna's beauty, Krishna's paraphernalia, Krishna's abode, Krishna's qualities. Become attached to Krishna. And automatically you develop detachment, material detachment, transcendental knowledge, everything. Vasudeve Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayojitaha Janayati Ashu Vairagyam Jnanam Chayadahaitukam. This verse means if you develop pure devotional service to Vasudeva, Krishna, then automatically you develop material detachment and transcendental knowledge without separate ending. We have heard that Krishna expanded to so many forms as were the number of gopis. I heard that there were billions of gopis. Krishna performed the rasa dance. What, these gopis from the Goloka Vrindavana? Yes, these gopis are from Goloka Vrindavana only. So, whatever the number of gopis, of course, they are really billions of gopis. But Krishna expands himself to as many forms as there are gopis. Krishna is not limited. Even in this material world, Krishna has expanded as Paramatma and entered the heart of every living being. Countless living beings are there. He has expanded as Paramatma and has entered the heart of every living being. Why just living beings? He has entered the every atom. So, Krishna is unlimited Lord. You can understand the meaning of the word unlimited only when it is applied to Krishna. And you hear of Krishna's pastime. Then you understand what is the import of that word unlimited, ananta. That's a Sanskrit word, ananta. Krishna is called ananta. Unlimited. So I'll stop here. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.